Sound is on. Okay.
Welcome.
Charlie Bush, the man with the infectious laugh.
I'm sure he never will stop laughing.
Welcome to Charlie Horse, the show that pulled your leg ever so slightly.
In the mid-70s, Charlie Bush was the host for a late-night, wee hours of the morning movie show on Channel 5, where he was master of the pun.
And listen to this, for a sofa, you want a sofa? Well, look, here's a sofa bed from $98. And I mean, White Bear Lake, that isn't so far to go for a sofa. It's not as far as Davenport. Well, what are we doing here? Hey.
But what Charlie Bush will always be most remembered for are his years on KSTP radio.
These were all a bunch of legendary outlaws who got together with Charlie. And as you can see from the picture, Charlie's the only one wearing a tie.
That period, a lot of renegades working there. It was really, a lot of wild guys working at that station in those days, very young. And Charlie was kind of the stabilizing force.
Charlie Bush was the stabilizing force that would help KSTP radio become a 1970s legend. But as he floated along in the business, he didn't know what fate was preparing. His television slide said, "Don't go away." But by late 1991, he would be doing just that. And as much as he would have liked to fight it, he will not be coming back. Cancer has made sure of that.
And we want to let everybody know that all these people who are here tonight,
everybody,
all of these people who are here all day are here for Charlie.
Roper's Bar and Restaurant, Fridley, Minnesota, October 20th, 1991. Hundreds show up for a benefit for the Charlie Bush family. Many remember the Charlie Bush that dates back to 1973, when he was first teamed up with Chuck Knapp on KSTP AM. The two quickly became the kings of rock and roll's morning radio kingdom.
I used to call him Goodyear on the air, and because I was so skinny, he called me Pencil Body.
Chuck, crap in the morning. Dumb jock, pencil body, briar patch chest, SOS pad nap. Thank you.
Well, didn't get all of them, but boy,
thank you.
Nice collection.
Nice collection. Thanks to you.
The show just grew by leaps and bounds almost overnight. And it's what is known in the broadcast industry as Hubbard's 100 Days. And that's out there documented, and that's what they called it, and it was the period of time that it took the radio station to go from worst to first.
The two became legendary, Chuck as the smart-aleck, fast-talking hippie, and Charlie as the bushy-browed banterer of broadcasting. He was a man of rhyme and reason, who rhymed often for good reason.
The Mounties are trying to flush out a person with a penchant for purloining potties. If they get hold of the man, they'll slap him in the can.
He was marvelously creative. He is. He's a marvelous. He's really a genius. He's a Jonathan Winters.
In August of 1975, Knapp and Bush made the cover of a nationally circulated trade magazine. The photos were of a now famous high noon showdown on 8th Street and Nicollet in Minneapolis.
I just pushed the pie for everything I had into his face, and I really enjoyed it. And the crowd was cheering and roaring, and Channel 5 was there, and they took it back and they put it on the news that night.
So Chuck Knapp and Charlie Bush have captured the 6 to 10 morning audience with their lively radio repartee and a shared fondness for cream pies. You see, they've got a lot of class, but it's mostly third.
No.
We're happy they're here working with us, and we're happy to be sharing with you the start of their third year on the air together.
And I really, all of these things that I carry, all these memories of Charlie, and I couldn't have done it without him, and just a great inspiration.
As a friend, even if you didn't know him or hadn't met him, you know you're listening in the morning to a friend of yours on the radio.
John Hines and Charlie Bush became a team in 1976. And then in 77, as part of a publicity stunt, they were even arrested.
My family's happy to have me here, actually. They figure it'll be a night off.
My wife won't miss me until Monday afternoon.
And then not much.
The KSTP broadcast team of Hines and Bush ended after just a few years. But their friendship lasted a lifetime.
And why I was so looking forward to come back and work with Charlie again 10 years later.
Hines and Bush with a new K102 lottery.
New numbers and new winners every hour.
Check your mailbox soon for your chance to win cash.
Nearly 10 years after the original team of Hines and Bush ended, they were together again.
K-102, the FM country. Coming up, Pam Lewis in for Charlie Bush with some news and information at the half-hour mark.
But the reunion would last less than a year. This time, cancer would make sure the separation would be permanent and painful.
There's a spark that's not in the hallway. There is, whether you are standing with Charlie and laughing about something, or hearing him in a different part of the building laughing with somebody else about something, that's not here.
People should remember him as a guy they listened to who really sincerely was having a lot of fun doing what he did, was very good at it, and had a lot of fun doing it. And maybe take a hint from that.
He'll always be with me, and he'll always be alive.
Charlie Bush, he is an irreplaceable voice. He is an irreplaceable friend.
People have said, you know, are you going to get another partner, somebody to replace Charlie? And that's a contradiction of terms. You can't get somebody to replace Charlie. Who knows? I mean, you know, there'll be other partners. I'll work with other people, but I won't get somebody to replace Charlie. We won't find somebody to do that.
Boy, I must have some kind of bad disease, huh?
On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 12 hanky-pankies, 11 views of heaven, 10 Libra lessons, 9 lovely live likes, 8 Marvy Moments, 7 sauna session, 6 silly gooses, 5 golden hours, 4 fever blisses, 3 Parker Tuckers, 2 happy hickeys, and the bird as I chased her around the tree.